I have 6 children. I had 7 before one passed away, and it was a hard time for me. I had to rebuild my life. I spoke with my caseworker, and he was like, well, I have a perfect program for you. And he told me to come over to the Y.
I moved to Troy with my fiance at the time. Things kind of went south. I was giving him money to pay the rent, and he wasn't doing such. Eviction notice on the door. Now, I'm fairly new to Troy. I needed shelter. Someone told me about the YWCA, and they seen that I just needed some help, just a break.
When I first came in here, my daughter was 8, and my son was 2. I was very nervous. I was going through a lot, and I didn't want no one around me, basically, so I like stayed to myself. So probably 2 months when I realized that everybody wanted to help me and my kids.
You can only stay at a homeless shelter so long, and I looked for apartments, I looked for work. It just didn't seem to open up. But there was a room open here, and they got me in here. And I really didn't know much about it, honestly. I was just glad to have my own room where I could just go in there and really heal and rest. And that's just what I did.
I moved here from New York City, a domestic violence shelter. It was just me, my 4 kids. We had maybe 3 garbage bags and 2 blankets, and that's how we were living here. I didn't know anything, and then I found this place. So, and they helped with everything. If I didn't find it, I don't know.
We are a national and an international organization. The YWCA started in the 1850s in London, and 30 years after that, the YWCA was founded in the city of Troy, and it's been over 130 years, and we're still here. The YWCA is dedicated to eliminating racism, empowering women, and promoting peace, justice, freedom, and dignity for all. We are one of the area's largest providers of supportive housing to both homeless, single women, and women with children. It's affordable housing and it's safe. We have our SRO program, which is a single room occupancy, and we have 76 permanent SROs in our building.
You guys like being with grandma?
We have a resident that has lived in our SRO program for 42 years and counting.
The women in transition is a little different. We call it the WIC program. And there we house single women and single women with children.
Some women are homeless. Some women are coming from jail. They may come from psychiatric centers. Some of them may potentially be living on the street, you know? So it's a more structured program. They have chores, they have curfew. It's really teaching them the skills that they need to be successful in their own home.
When you walk into a situation and it's foreign to you, you don't know what to expect. You're trying to keep everything together. But here, you're just so welcomed and you're just so wanted. Like, that's how it is here.
We have women that come in here, they could be transgender, black, white, whatever color they are. We don't see that. We see people and they're treated with the same respect.
You know, a lot of people don't know. We have women here that have been professors. We have women here that have had their own businesses. We have women that have been very, very successful in their life. And unfortunately, because of a disability or because of domestic violence, they have lost it all. You know, and they're here and they need this place. The Jamison Rounds Ready for Work program was created to help women to prepare them for work. They're here 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., Monday through Friday, for 12 weeks. There's a lot of workshops on dressing for success, work etiquette.
They helped with resume writing, taught us interview techniques.
They showed us PowerPoints, Excel.
Even the people that aren't my counselors, they'll come in and help me in the computer room.
Math and reading was really what I was looking for, and I got that help. When we leave here, they make sure we have all the tools we need to make it.
The graduation means a lot to people, seeing their family there for that big moment that they work hard for 3 months. You know, and I tell them, you did it. I was just there to lead you, you know, in that direction, but you did all this work.
I'm feeling excited, I'm feeling ecstatic, and I'm very proud of myself.
Some of the women in this video went through the Ready for Work program. Asia actually was a resident here at the YWCA. She went through our Jamison Rounds Ready for Work program, and for 6 years, she has been working for us full time.
Working for the YWCA, the Greater Capital Region, is where I'm supposed to be.
Wilhelmina inspires me. A position became available in the Jamison Rounds Ready for Work program, and she applied for it, and she's been doing such an amazing job for over a year.
I started off being in the program, and look where I'm at now. I love working with women that were in the same boat as me. I couldn't think of anything else that I wanted to do but work with women and show them the same support I got.
I've seen people grow here. That's what's exciting. The young ones are going to these classes and they're going to cooking school now and they're finding jobs and they're excited.
I was once homeless too, and this is my way of giving back to the community.
We're really about giving more than just second chances. It's doing the great work that we do here.
We really are doing big things.
For someone that has been through so much in their life, and to be standing tall, to be making incredible strides, to be accomplishing their goals, that's hope. For someone to transition from a domestic violence shelter and to be living here, and to be doing well, and to feel safe, that's hope. All the services that we provide, it's hope. It's about empowerment.
The YWCA of the Greater Capital Region is a place that you can come and feel that you have a support system.
People like me, you know, need places like this.
The YWCA is a lot of things to people. Hope, yes. Refuge, yes. Sanctuary, yes.
It feels like happiness. The YWCA of the Capital Region is a giant safety net and opportunity for people to heal, grow, and get on with life.
I truly don't know where I would be if it wasn't for the YWCA.
They believed in me when I didn't believe that I could get that far.
I'm capable of a lot more than what I thought. They gave me the tools to get to where I needed to be.
I really like who I am now, you know, and who I become. This is the greatest reward. I don't know what anybody else's reward is that they're looking for in life, but this is mine.
The YWCA has given me hope, and it helps me to appreciate life in general more.
I'm grateful for the YWCA and all that they have done for me and my son and all the ladies that come through our doors.
I was a resident here for a year, and now I got my own apartment.
I'm going for my degree. Gonna get that degree. Then I'll be doing this type of stuff.
This is an amazing program, and I'm not just saying that because I'm involved or I work here. I'm saying it because it changed my life. I just can't wait to see how many more women we can help, how many more programs we can open up to them.
It's so important for the YWCA to raise money. We have an anonymous donor that will donate $2,500 to us for every $10,000 we raise. Our mission really impacts the population we serve. It's a very daring mission, and we're doing it.